Good morning. Welcome to St. Lucie Parish. Thank you for joining us for the fifth Sunday of Easter. As we prepare for Mass this morning, we invite you to create a sacred space in your home, light a candle, eliminate any distractions that might take you away from this prayerful experience. God bless you.
O Lord my God, when I am awesome wonder, consider all the words thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sing my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. In a special way, we greet those mothers who are watching. Happy Mother's Day. It's a great blessing to celebrate this special day with you. We wish you could be here with us. We wish we could be with you. But we are united in this Eucharistic communion, this Eucharistic hope, this Eucharistic blessing that Jesus offers to us. And on this day where we honor our mothers, we especially recognize the place of our Blessed Mother Mary within our church, within our hearts, as she is our mother who watches over all mothers. But as we prepare to enter into these sacred mysteries of Christ's life, death, and resurrection, we call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came for all sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father where you intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because of their widows, because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you several reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community. So they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit. Also, Philip, Procurus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you. Lord, let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you. Exalt you, just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on high. With a 10-stringed lyre, chant his praises. Lord, let your mercy be on us, as we place our trust in you. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in scriptures, behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, I have been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen. Amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, there is, at the beginning of today's gospel, a brief word of Jesus to which little attention is usually paid. You have faith in God? Have faith in me, he says to the apostles gathered around him for the Last Supper. So, can one believe in God without having faith in Jesus Christ? Of course, you will say. This is true for all believers who are not Christians, and they are very numerous. Yes, but Jesus speaks to his disciples, to his apostles. That is, to us. And he suggests that one can have faith in God without really believing in him, Jesus. So he said to his apostles, you have faith in God, have faith also in me. This morning, the exchange that Jesus has with two of his disciples helps us to better understand what it means to have faith in Jesus Christ. Delicately, as he usually does, Jesus will show his interlocutors that they do not really know him, and therefore that they do not really believe in him. It is in this sense that Saint Augustine often insisted on the link between faith and knowledge. He wrote, "Believe and you will know. If you don't know, you don't believe. You don't really believe." We then understand why Jesus said to Philip, "I have been with you for so long, and you do not know me." Yes, the Lord himself walked with Philip and all his other apostles under the sun and the dust of Palestine, and they did not know. With them, however, the living gospel was there, without protocol, without explanation. He was there, uncovered, this Jesus, Son of God, and God himself. "Whoever has seen me has seen the Father." And what about us today? We may still be waiting for this God of the gospel. We may be waiting for him spectacularly. But he is already there, simply. And that is the problem. Our expectation is immense. It is even meant to be magical. It is enough to make a list of all we expect from God in our prayers of intercession. It would be long and of all kinds. With such an expectation, how could we recognize the presence of God, the God of the gospel, who works by our side? This can be practically impossible. Nevertheless, the good news we have just heard is that somehow God is there, mind of nothing. He is there, whispering to us, I have been with you for so long. And if at times I'm disconcerting, it is because I did not come into the world to seduce you. I am not a landmark among others. I am your God, and I stand among you. However, you disguise me as a magician and as alien benefactor. Yet John the Baptist had told you, in the midst of you stands one whom you do not know. Is there a greater preaching on God? No. Then believe, I am at your side. What does all this mean, brothers and sisters? It means just that we can miss God. It means that if we miss God, it is not because He's not there, but perhaps because we pass by Him. Yes, if we miss God, it is not because He's not there, but it may be because we pass by Him. And in order not to miss Him, we have to look. And to look, we have to stop. To stop means not looking for too many complicated things. To stop means not to look too far. How many in our families go around the Christian churches other than Catholic in search of a spectacular God? Someone once said, the proclamation of the gospel is not often spectacular. And when it is spectacular, it is not often the gospel. So let us not look too far, brothers and sisters. Let us follow Peter's recommendation in today's second reading, which is quite simple. Come to Him. Get close to Him. This is what Peter tells us. Come to Jesus, the living stone. Come near to Him. Because in Him, you have the way. Get closer to Him. Because through Him, you have the truth. Approach Him, because with Him, you will receive the life that has no end, that which belongs to the new world. So once again, brothers and sisters, let us not look for things that are too complicated. Let us contemplate Jesus in the pages of the Gospels. There, it is given to us to know Him better, especially when sharing the gospel with the family. Let us contemplate Him in the Eucharist, in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, in that heart-to-heart, which is not first intellectual, but rather spiritual communion. Spiritual communion. And finally, Let us contemplate him in the relationships we have with our brothers and sisters in life. By contemplating in their faces what is beautiful, what is great, what is truth, in order to see in it Christ himself, who wants to lead us to the Father. Lord Jesus, you who are the way, the truth, and the life, grant us to contemplate you today in our sisters and brothers. May we be able to contemplate you spiritually in the Eucharist, and also to contemplate you in your saving word, the gospel. Amen.
This time to please stand as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God has made us a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a people set apart, and so we can pray for all those in need.
For the Catholic Church throughout the world, for the charitable work done in the name of Jesus, that it will continue to change lives and hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may live as God's chosen people and follow Christ, who is our way, our truth, and our life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers and those who have shown us a mother's love, that God will watch over them, bless them with every good gift, and fill their hearts with peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, particularly those with COVID, that God will restore them to health and guide researchers in finding effective treatments and developing a vaccine, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially our mothers, John Nguyen and Teresa Sanchez Coronado, that God will welcome them into the peace and joy and presence of God's presence forever, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of this Mass, for Maxine Henderson and Nora Haggerty, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. And for your prayers, which you hold within the silence of your hearts, we pray to the Lord. God of love, your only Son, Jesus Christ, shows us the way to you. Teach us to follow him more closely. When we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. This time as we prepare the altar of the Lord, I'd invite you, if you are able to either text to give. After Mass is over, set up an electronic giving account, or for those who have been dropping their envelopes off at the parish or mailing it in, thank you very much. Your generosity is greatly appreciated during this time.
Let all who thirst, let them come to the water. And let all who have nothing, let them come to the Lord without money, without price. Why should you pay the price except for the Lord? And let all who see, let them come to the water. And let all who have nothing, let them come to the Lord without money, without strife. Why should you spend your life except for the Lord. Pray,
friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of
God. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with this sacrificial offering, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples. Memory of me.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church, straightened out the holy, rebirth to the fullness of charity. Francis, Aupo, Oscar, our bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Brothers and sisters, at the Savior's command, informed by divine say, Our Father, who art in heaven, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us turn to one another and offer a sign of Christ's peace. Thank you.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Please join us in praying together the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. If we have died with him, then we shall live with him. If we hold firm, we shall reign with him. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. If anyone serves me, then they must follow me. Wherever I am, my servants will be. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life.
Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we'll have a blessing of all mothers just in a few seconds here, but we have a couple other announcements. Those who are receiving sacraments, both First Communion and Confirmation, as soon as we have news for you, we will let you know. We are pushing as hard as we can to move forward on this. It's a difficult thing, I know that. We are making plans. Once we know what we're permitted to do and we're not permitted to do, we are, you know, sacramentally or gathering as a number of people, we will work on that, but we are not forgotten. That's what I want to say. Whether you wanted to receive the Easter sacraments or confirmation as a teenager or adult or First Eucharist, we have not forgotten you. Please, with that, I do want to say thank you very much again to all our volunteers, both with the Friday food handout, but also we've had many volunteers do many, many wonderful things between helping to clean the church as we put it back together, helping to make phone calls to all of you in the parish, and the other things they're doing that are just slipped my mind. But it is one of those blessings that can never be said enough. We do thank you also for your support, both financially and through prayer. As I mentioned during the preparation of the gifts, it's an important thing to do. So we thank you for that. And volunteers, did a Bible study, thank you. We have a golf tournament that was supposed to happen on May the 1st, my birthday. And we'll get to May birthdays in a minute because I forgot them last week. We are having an auction, and Andrew is going to play you a little video now. And so I'm trusting that he's doing it because I can't see anything because it's all done on a little computer screen.
Annual St. Lucie Golf Tournament, but because of this craziness, it was canceled, so Father Steve, Mrs. Grover and I are having a match play to see who the championship golfer of St. Lucie will be for 2020. So please help us and donate to the golf tournament to support Camp Thrive and the other ministries.
I just transferred to St. Lucie, and my reading was not the best. I didn't really like to read, but then
going to come up. So it's online. So please watch it. There's going to be different auction items there. Father Steve, Father Joseph, and I are going to be making a grand batch of limoncello that we're going to have for little auction items. We don't know quite how we're going to do it yet, but please, before that, and many other wonderful things to help support scholarships for Camp Thrive, our school, and our parish community for our children. So it's a wonderful way to support that. Before we bless our mothers, we're going to do a happy birthday to all of those in May. So if you celebrated birthday in May, like I have done, Father Steve Brown was on the same day as me, May the 1st. The day after that was Father Joe Kim and Father Monsignor Francisco Rios. And I'm sure there's other priests, but I'm sure there's many of you who had a blessing. So if you have a birthday boy or girl in your house, lay your hands upon them, extend them, give them a hug or a kiss, and we bless them. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life. Bless these, your sons and daughters, who celebrate their birthday in May. May they be full of joy, peace, and love. Amen. Now, those of you who have celebrated marriages this month, united, woohoo, right? Let's take your bride or your groom into the hands, and let us pray a blessing over you. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of marriage, which is the sign of your Trinitarian love in the world. Help these, your sons and daughters, grow ever closer in love and peace as husband and wife. Strengthen them in their troubles. Be with them in their joy. Amen. And now the day...
the day. It's Mother's Day. It's a great blessing. Mothers are such a wonderful blessing. And right on top of her, right near her, and extend a hand of blessing over her. If she's far away, get that. Let us bless our mothers. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, moms. Anyway, so once again, we are praying for you. We're praying that soon we can gather into the beautiful church again. Continue to pray for that. Continue to advocate for that. Continue to say continue to feed that desire to be here with us. Thank you. Thank you to Father Joseph for such a wonderful and holy homily, Father Steve, for coming with us today and being with us behind me, making sure I didn't make any mistakes, right? Yeah, okay. To our lector, Pam, to our wonderful musicians on the side over here, Arturo, our acolyte, and our tech support, Andrew, today. He's here all by himself, as our mother, who usually helps us, is with her family at home. But we continue to work to make it better. Hopefully it was a wonderful, holy experience for you today with not too many glitches, okay? The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Peace, alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God, alleluia.
Hail, Holy Queen, enthroned above, O Maria. Hail, Mother of Mercy and of love, O Maria. Triumph, all ye cherubim, sing with us, ye seraphim. Heaven and earth resound the hymn, Salve, 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 Regina. Our life, our sweetness here below, O Maria. Our hope in sorrow and in woe, O Maria. Triumph, all ye cherubim, sing with us, ye seraphim. Heaven and earth resound the hymn, Salve, Salve.